Dear subscribers, you're in for a rare treat. Behold, an object moving at the speed of light. Okay, that was too fast. Let me try something. If I bump up the frames per second and turn on the slow motion camera so we can see things slowly enough, what would an object traveling at near light speed look like? This is the final installment of a little video trilogy about the visual reality of the effects of relativity. Because as we've learned, there's a difference between what I see and what actually happens. We have to pay attention not only to the physical phenomena that affects objects as they approach the speed of light, but also to what happens to the light beams that bounce off those objects. After all, they're the ones who give us all the info. And of course, when the object we're seeing moves just as fast as those light beams, things get weird. Imagine a cube passes by you at near light speed. While that cube has a certain depth, which means the rays of light coming from the far side will take longer to reach us than the ones from the near side. It's in the past. If we add movement to this, we observe the same thing we did with a car. Each of the light beams that enter your eye simultaneously belongs to a separate part of the cube at a different moment in time. Being further back in time also means being farther back. So ultimately, what the camera records is an object that's been rotated. This is called Torell rotation. You'll notice I didn't need any fancy tricks to illustrate it. This isn't a relativistic phenomenon. In fact, if the universe didn't follow the rules of relativity, what we'd see would be a very elongated cube moving toward us that contracts and starts to rotate as it comes closer. At a certain point, we'd begin to see the side of the cube we shouldn't even be able to visualize, but which this optical effect shows us. But of course, the world is relativistic, which means the cube will be contracted because it's moving. It turns out that when you factor in expansion, these two effects sort of cancel each other out, and it's not so easy to see the contraction happening. However, Torell rotation is so obvious, you can't miss it. But there's one case where optical expansion and Lorentz contraction cancel each other out perfectly. A sphere. Imagine a soccer ball moving in a straight line through space. If there was no relativity, we'd see it elongated as it moves. But when Lorentz contractions come into play, the two effects offset each other, and even with Torell contraction, we see a spherical ball. When some wise guy comes along and says, "Hey, the Earth could be flat. If you move really fast, you get Lorentz contraction, and it looks like..." No, it doesn't. But there's another problem. It's not just the fact that we have the Doppler effect. In other words, the object's color is modified by wavefront emission. It's that this Doppler effect is now relativistic. This means that since the speed of light has to be the same for everybody, the amount of light emitted by each part of the object changes. It seems to be concentrated in the direction of travel. This is something called relativistic beaming. Particle physicists and astrophysicists are well acquainted with this phenomenon. Consequently, the object would seem very bright when approaching, but as it came nearer and moved out of the shaft of compressed light, it would gradually become more and more translucent. Fewer rays would reach our eyes until the object finally disappeared. This is why I told you Lorentz contraction can't be seen. For our conclusion, let's return to the spaceship. What would we see inside a rocket traveling at near light speed? Well, let's look at the best case scenario first. Traveling at high speed is basically the same as having everything else move toward you at the same speed. And I'm sure you'll also agree that light from the stars in the center will reach us faster than the light from the stars in the corners. Therefore, the farther the star is from the center, the further in the past you'll see it. In other words, further back. The result is a kind of fisheye lens. Of course, if you're traveling too fast, at over 90% the speed of light, the Doppler effect alters light enough that it shifts to the ultraviolet spectrum. And if that happens, you won't see a thing. Huh. Space is a tough place. And that's it for today. We'll be back soon with a bit more science. And as always, thanks for watching.